Hello, everybody. Welcome to Thursday. The S&P 500 was up 0.5% today. And actually, everything was up. The NASDAQ was down at the beginning of the day, but it turned around and came up. The Russell 2000, the Dow, it was actually a pretty good day. We had some record closes for a whole bunch of the stocks, indexes, even though, you know, they weren't huge days, but, you know, we've been kind of crawling up at a pretty nice pace, actually. The big news that came out today really, again, had to do with employment. This is kind of the employment week as a whole. Tomorrow is the big number. You know, how many new jobs were created? Expectation is 700,000. We'll find out tomorrow morning, and I'll report that in tomorrow's weekly summary. But today, what they report is how many people claimed unemployment, really kind of first-time claims. And it was the lowest it's been since the pandemic started. And so that's a good sign that continues to come down. So the labor market's getting a little bit better as far as that goes. And we're starting to see some recovery there. We did see a little bit of, you know, run up on the 10-year treasury based on that number. Again, if you watch really closely for inflationary pressure, it often revolves around employment. Because it's one of the biggest costs for companies as far as that goes. So tomorrow's going to be watched pretty heavily as far as that goes. We'll see what happens, but things are doing pretty well. Value did better today in our portfolios than some of the growth pieces. One area that's been running quite nicely recently is kind of that advanced healthcare area, the genomics and what have you, that did really well, you know, really this time last year, and everything in that kind of area hit a peak mid-February. But we're seeing a pretty good recovery and a re-movement back into that area. We've seen energy and oil do quite well in this environment also. Matter of fact, the price of crude got over $75 really for the first time in a while. Oil's a weird deal because, you know, there's a lot of people that could produce more if they wanted to. And so when the price gets up pretty high, you know, sometimes they'll turn them up a bit and that'll bring down the price. So it can be a little bit of a volatile commodity as far as that goes. But it does show an increasing world demand. And I think slowly but surely we're seeing, you know, all kinds of things that are happening globally, where we're seeing, you know, the mobility data that shows how much people are moving around, getting closer and closer to where it was, you know, February of 2020 before the pandemic. Still has a ways to go, especially in some of these countries, but it's going in the right direction. And so things are starting to improve here altogether, and we'll see what that means. You know, again, the real key here is that you don't want the economy to do too poorly and you don't want it to do too well either as far as the stock market's concerned. Right now, because of what's happening internationally, it looks like, you know, our stock market is being allowed to kind of float along in what I call this Goldilocks zone. And so that's a good thing too. So anyway, look forward to talking to you tomorrow. We're having our, Talk Money with Tom show tomorrow, 12:15 to 1 o'clock. Feel free to join us, send in any questions as soon as you want or during the show. And we can answer those also. And I'll be doing a summary for the week tomorrow. So you can see that also and see what I thought kind of was important for this week as far as that goes. So look forward to talking to you tomorrow. Thank you very much.